Hello. Gonna rattle. Well, let's get out of here. Just 2 degrees. Into Milton Keynes there, straight on site ish. And then we go from there. After time now.
A mile, keep right, then take the exit.
What? So see if we got the litter pickers out. How risky is that? So I was just up from Sutton, Scotland, and they do a fantastic job. Look, it's spotless. But that won't take long before just up from Sutton, Scotland, it's just covered in shit again. Wrong, innit? Old cost, four blokes there and a van. Well, I didn't succumb to a McDonald's breakfast. I had Greek yogurt, dried fruit and nut mix with a little spoonful of honey. Big bowl of it. Most fit in my beard and down my front. Yeah, there's a picture. Conjure that one up. possible until January 23. Oh, we're in 23, aren't we? Yeah. Of course we are. I was thinking, bloody hell, oh yeah, it is. No, we're already in 23, aren't we? Doing a load of aliens, but I don't know what they're doing along here. Oh, they've emptied the lay-by out though. Put all this railing in on the left look. New barrier. Alco barrier? Finished. Just waiting for a better cone redeployment. Unless they're replacing all of this, in which case, crack on. Down here. There's a digger. And looks like the coal stopped work. Here comes. Barrier here. Cruising at 53 mile an hour along the A34 northbound, and that was Milton Keynes. And estimated time of arrival is 12:17. Who knows how long the tip's going to be? We'll work out what happens next, so I'll speak to you later. Hello. Traffic lights. Time now 11:44. That coffee, 3 degrees. Loads of filthy spray coming up. And the A421, and apparently there's some hold up ahead. Hey, let's go. Although it's dull and overcast, the light is quite, it almost makes you squint a bit, you know? Funny light. For the ride, really. I've seen all this loads of time, but you never know what you're going to see, do you?
After a quarter of a mile, cross the roundabout and take the second exit, A421, Tinchwick bypass. So far at 10 to 12 in the morning. Started off at Chesterfield, down to Southampton, back out to Milton Keynes.
is.
Cross the roundabout and take the second exit.
Was there any real need for that? I don't know. But, he's got there, he's got ahead of me. Want to take that chance because he brought some speed into that roundabout. Perhaps I'll just drive too cautiously. I don't know. Some snowdrops at one, it was just thunder.
Cross the roundabout and take the second exit.
Frosty ground. Bit more spoon rolling around in the mug. Every time you stop, you've got to clean your lights.
Cross the roundabout and take the second exit.
Almost some. I think I just had me impacted by the papper. Full winter spec today. Telling me to go quicker going left, I'm not going to though.
Go right on the roundabout and take the second exit.
So, take our chance. Unless the road is shut, of course, in which case, kind of wrong way. arrive at 12:30. Which is, bang on. Check in to make sure I am going to the right place. It's occurring. What's occurring? Roof.
After 200 feet, cross the roundabout and take the second exit, A421.
Something going on just the other side of the roundabout here. Well, I was going to have an omelette when I got here, but I don't know if I'm going to bother. Movement. Not much. Get off of it. a bit on and off all the way along this road. I don't know what appears to be the problem. Once had a look at one of those Isuzu pickups. It had done really low motor, it was silver. And the pictures, it looked amazing. It was silver, it was only about 3 or 4 years old. Low mileage. And I couldn't for the life of me work out why it was so cheap. Silver leather interior, just really high spec, aircon, all the bits and pieces. I just couldn't fathom it out. I thought, and it was from an Isuzu dealer. I think it was only 3 or 4 years old. It was, wasn't very old at all. So I thought, I've got to go and have a look at this. So I went and had a look, and the bloke goes, and the salesman said, yeah, he said, it was owned by a farmer. I went, right. And he said, right, we've given it its initial clean, but we need to do some more work on it. I went, right. And I said, well, let's go and have a look. And I was looking around the outside, and it was immaculate outside. Not a dent, not a chip, not a scratch, just really good. And then I opened the door, and the smell hit me. Smell of cow shit. And I looked at a leather steering wheel, silver leather steering wheel, and it was just ingrained with shit. It wasn't even silver, and you could see bits of it where it was silver, but the rest of the time it was black and grey and browny coloured, and all the leather seats were all brown and stained, and it was like, and I said, you've already had a go then, because the carpet wasn't too bad, well, bits of it. Plastic was all right, but the carpet right where the feet were, but it just stunk, and all the leather was ingrained. He said, well, yeah, I said no wonder you got it down at that price. I mean, somebody will take it off your hands, but it won't be me. Oh my word. I mean, you would have I don't know whether you actually would have got it clean again. It was bad, really ingrained. You'd have thought if you're the farmer, you'd have put covers on it, wouldn't you? What is going on here? We're going to dual carriageway in a minute. I did take it out for a drive. It was a really nice drive as well, which is a bit of a shame, even more of a shame. Oh, do come on. Good places to be. Like back in my bed. Truck needs a good clean. On the inside, let alone the outside. It's minging in it. Dust, I don't know where all the dust comes from. Not really, that is. It's more dusty during the winter than it is during the summer. I don't know. What is going on? If it's an accident, I hope everyone's alright, because being sat this long, that's not good. But if it's just a bit of fuckwittery, then... I won't be overly impressed. Well, nothing you can do. Nothing you can do. It's still alright for time. Was a set of traffic lights. The camera decided to switch itself off. They were digging a hole in the bank. Telecoms or something like that, I think. Anyway, that's what the hold up was, so nothing traumatic, thankfully. Loads of roundabouts.
After 900 feet, cross the roundabout and take the second exit, A421, standing way. Cross the roundabout and take the second exit.
In the back of your head going around here. Come at you from all angles. You've got to be careful you don't overcook it on the roundabouts. You come in too fast and can't stop. Or they're signalling to exit off and then they keep on coming round. In and go across Watling Street.
A421 standing way.
I told you I used to have an office here when I had a Proper job.
Cross the roundabout and take the second exit.
Let's go. Signal, couldn't tell. Silver car, where are you going? That way? Yep. Guess what? Tucked in. Oh, I'm coming up the left hand side now, I'm pulling out. We're through.
Take the exit, A5.
No one coming around the outside of me. Good. Keep an eye on them.
After 1 mile, take the exit of 1146 towards Milton, Keynes, south and east.
Visibility.
Go left on the roundabout and take the first exit of 1146 towards Milton Keynes East.
Now, anybody who thought this was designed with horses and cars in mind, you know?
Go left on the roundabout and take the first exit.
But it's, you know, it's relatively new. Just and just make it out. Once you're committed, you've got to keep going. I wouldn't want to do that junction on my test because there's a high possibility of getting it wrong then. You're either lucky and you get out or you make someone slow down. It's that simple. Because you just don't get the visibility. They come round so fast and there's about 30, 40 metres. Probably less than that. Is that frozen? There's not even the length of a No, it's not even 30 metres. It's the length of an Arctic. It's the only visibility that you get.
After 900 feet, cross the roundabout and take the second exit of 1146 Fletcher Way. Cross the roundabout and take the second exit.
Well, I tend to go up, round the roundabout and back down again. That road going, I can go right there and then turn left, and it brings me out in the same place, but it's so bumpy. You're either going to lose a filling or shorten your spine by about 3 centimetres. I'm sure that tipper was parked there last time I come up here. Go on, blue van, get past me. Time today.
After 900 feet, go around the roundabout and take the fourth exit of 1146 Fletcher Way. Go around the roundabout and take the fourth exit.
Later on. Speak to you later. See how long we're in here, whether it's going to be a quick dip or a long dip. Speak to you later. Hello. Time now, 14:45. No plan for tomorrow yet. Who knows? So we're just we're going back a slightly, well, we're going back a different way. You can only assume that the road that was traffic lighted is completely snarled up now, so it's diverting me back this way. Do it for a change. I'm aiming to get to Chilwell Valley. Sure. clean truck, he won't stay clean for long, will he? Put too much time on your hand, fella. Hello. So we've just left Milton Keynes. I was in there. I think I've already said that. I don't know. I don't know if I said anything or not. Was I recording going out the A5? I don't know. I won't know until I review the footage. I don't know what I have and what I haven't done. So anyway, HS2 work's going on here. Get me ready to go. Yep. Started Sunday. I those wipers on intermittent. They're just not having it at all.
After half a mile, go left on the roundabout and take the first exit, A43.
See if there's a street light down. There's normally a street light here down on the left. As soon as they put it back up, it gets knocked down again. That one's there. Oh, look at it. Look at the state of it. Look, it's not even got the light on it this time.
Go left on the roundabout and take the first exit.
It's taking the sign out. It's a busy old road to get out of here. Something to my left. Right, nearly there.
Follow A43 for 3 miles.
Be a bit later getting here than I am. Thought I'd be here at 4, I'm going to be here by 3:30, which does mean that gives me a half hour extra wiggle room in the morning to go get diesel, so that's quite good. It'll be nice and quiet. Be starting around, it's better than that. busy. There they go. And driving, we've just crept into our 13th.